Me for 2 years, but it's finally run out, so I've got a new one. It's by a company called Scribbles That Matter. This is the box that it came in. It's an A5 dotted journal on 160 GSM paper, which is thicker than my last bullet. Mean that there's less pages. There's only 160 in this one. It means that the pen doesn't bleed as badly, and so it looks nicer, but it also means that it'll only probably last me a year, year and a half tops, whereas my last one lasted 2 years. There's key code page, 3 index tables, a pen test page, the standard expandable back pocket, 2 colour bookmarks, elastic closure, a riveted pen loop, vegan leather. I'm not bothered about vegan leather, but it's nice to know that for those who do care, this is something they can enjoy. So it's got this really nice design on the front, it's really cute. And inside, it's got this is how I do my annotations. So I do a square for a task or to do. I do a line with an arrow if it's been migrated. I colour in if it's completed. And then appointments and events. I also, I guess, cross out if it's been abandoned, which I haven't really, or just no longer required, which I haven't put on here, which I can do. I've got appointments and events, which are coloured in if they're attended. And then I colour code. So I use different colour for every month just to make it colourful and interesting. And so far my index, I've got a 2020 calendex, ASMR planning, course tracker, and household projects list. So I have nothing personal in here of great significance, so I'm just going to flick through. So like here's my calendex, I put in if I'm working, and things like birthdays, and any holidays and things, with days, months, so I do 6 monthly. There's another one here. The other half of the year, I then have got weekly spreads where I have Monday through Sunday down the side with any activities happening, a to-do list for the week rather than for the days, and the things like, for example, give the cat a bath, I'll talk about that later, file a complaint for the vets, again, I might talk about that, and then I've done up to the end of February and the 1st of March. I've then got ASMR planning. So I plan to do 3 videos a week as my goal. Sometimes in the past I have achieved that, and with some regularity, but the last few months have been shocking. So as you see, the first week I've started this, I haven't even got 1 video up, but this week I'll have this video at least. And I've got a heap of ideas. I've got my course tracker. So I need to actually continue working on my course. So again, I'm going to come back to what's been happening with me, but as we can see, my course, I was doing some studying on the 20th of November, and I did an assignment on the 20th of November, and I have done nothing since the 20th of November, which is shocking, because I was like, I should be up to here. rehearsal to-do list. I've got projects by room. So we've got a lot of things to do that I want to do around the house. And then I've got like goals for 2020, which are on this bit of paper, which I'm going to write up neatly in here. And then other than that, it's brand new. I like this back page. And then we've got a pen test page, which I haven't actually used because I trusted it was better than the last one. I just cracked out using my pens. So the pens I use is Stadler pigment liner. I've got 0.1, 0.5. I used to use 0.7 and 0.3, but they've kind of run out of ink because I've used them for 2 years. And then I've got the Pilot V5 High Tech Point 0.5 in blue. And then I've got Stadler Boss Pastel Highlighters. I've got a whole pack of them. And then I've got the Stadler Tri Plus Fine Liners. And again, I've got a whole packet of them. And I have got the Stadler Color, and again, a whole packet of them. I've got a stencil, which I got on Amazon, and then I've got a pencil, which is a Graph Gear 1000, which is struggling to focus. Graph Gear 1000 Pentel 0.7 mechanical pencil. And then I've got some stuff in there which is to do with like my college stuff. But this is my bullet journaling stuff. So that's sort of my setup for the new year. So to explain the lack of coursework, the lack of videos. Basically, I have been really ill. Tell you what, I might just be colouring in while I talk. I'm just gonna get these pens open. Gosh, what to colour in? So basically, I have been really burly since like the end of November. So I had this. I'm just holding the camera, the phone in my hand, so this is going to be wobbly. So I got a cold at the end of November. Which then proceeded to last for 2 months so that's what, 2 months now. I went to the doctors a few weeks ago and it turned out sinus infection, so I ended up on antibiotics. Now you can't really do ASMR videos when you are full of the cold and coughing and sneezing and snorting and generally making disgusting noises. So that's why I've been AWOL from making videos for a little while. Also I had a wisdom tooth out, so I had to fly down to the mainland UK to have a wisdom tooth out. Under general anaesthetic. As that was quite a big deal. Also, because of between the wisdom tooth and the cold, I stopped taking my Crohn's medication because it's immune suppressing. And I got away with it for a little while, and then I basically went into a flare up. So I've had to go back on my medication. It's been the festive, and I went away to the mainland to buy a new car because we've been struggling trying to make do with just one car. And when both my husband and I work, and there's no public transport where we are, then it's been kind of tricky. So it's been an interesting while. But, yeah, so I have been poorly. I've not been well with the cold. And the weather's been disgusting. And it's been a bit tough. I've also had a really tough start to my year because one of my cats almost died. She ate a rabbit and ate the whole thing. Skin, fur, bones, the lot. And as a result, ended up basically blocking herself up with all of that. And I had to go to the vets. The vets then sent her home earlier than they should have when they'd finished sorting her out, and she never really came around from the anaesthetic that they gave her properly, and ended up dehydrated, and she hadn't been eating. She was in a really bad way, and I had to send her back, and it's cost me a lot of money, which I didn't really have, and a lot of stress because I thought I was going to lose my baby girl. She's back home, and she's kind of more back to herself. Her and her sister are both put out because they're getting kept indoors at the moment. Because I have to keep an eye on her for the next few weeks. So that's why I had to give my cat a bath, and I had to put her complaint into the vets. So it's been a really stressful little while. So I've been unwell, my cat's been unwell. I've had to go buy a new car. I've had a wisdom tooth out. It's just been, it's been pretty hectic. It's been interesting because I've been doing an activity where I've been taking old diaries from like years ago, and I've been typing up the contents so that I can throw away the, I'm just going to take all the colours out of my little duogram, it'll make life easier. So I've been throwing away all of my old diaries, writing up the contents first, and it's interesting because like 5 years ago I was married before, and my life back then was literally work and housework and maybe some form of exercise, whether it was running or horse riding or what have you, but it was literally like work and trying to keep fit. So So I then like compared it to my life now. It's really funny because, oh yeah, so sorry, that was my life like a few years ago, like about 5 years ago, sort of 2015 and before. So, like, my life was church, it was work, it was volunteering, it was motorbikes, it was working my part-time job as well. I was traveling to visit with my partner. It was just flat out busy, busy, busy. Things have calmed down and like they're really quiet now, and I've given up Facebook. It's something I do regularly. I normally give it up for Lent, but I've given up Facebook, and I've been finding it really difficult this time. I said it's something I've been doing for years. This has been the hardest year so far. And I think it's just because, like, I've given up for January. And I think it is just because this year I have got like a completely different routine, and I just don't really know what to do with dead time that we fill with social media, with just mindless scrolling, and I haven't figured out what to do with that dead time yet. And so it's something I'm working on and just taking my time with. And this video is actually going to be much good because I'm kind of just rambling, but hopefully that's okay. So yeah, basically I've been unwell, life has been interesting, like I still love living here, it's my life is so much better than it used to be, but there's adjusting that still needs to be done. A change is hard. Even when it's for the better, you still take time to adjust. And I'm just in that transition phase of finding my feet and figuring things out. I'm hoping now to, I'm starting to kind of, I feel like I'm making progress with that. So I'm hoping that I'll be doing more videos more regularly. It's been just a really rough start to the year. I just felt really battered around. But I know it'll all kind of sort itself out. Another thing I was going to do is I was going to show you around my office. So I'm currently sitting at my desk. So my desk is a mess. So I've got some catalogues here which I'm going to do some ASMR videos with. I've got my headphones and my computer. I've got a cup and a dry erase board and pens and a pile of rubbish. This teddy that Christmas, a desk tidy organizer, and this over here, I'm going to do a video that's full of pens and stationery stuff. We're going to go through that at some point. This will be back up. So the window outside, the desk, above the desk, there's going to be a notice board, magnetic notice board, and some fairy lights. Then over here, we've got my bookshelf. A whole bunch of things, including a kitty and my blue yeti hanging from it, which I'm not using for this video. So we have a kitty cat who's looking a bit bald in places, and unfortunately her little bum end is all bald. She's had a really rough time, but she's doing much better than she was. Little pumpkin. He's like, what's going on? So I've got heaps of stuff. I've got scrapbooking stuff. I've got folders under the desk. I've got my bin I made in high school out of wood. Drove the teacher insane making something so complicated. We've got another cat bed under the bed and the desk with a basket of cat toys. I need to hoover in here. There's cat hair everywhere. And then around here we've got my toolbox, which shouldn't be in here. More cat beds. Guitar I bought years ago, which I can't actually play, but it's too pretty to part with. This clock's gonna go up on the wall at some point, and the battery needs replaced. It's dead. I've got boxes of things. So this unit here, all that's gonna get cleared off. I'm gonna have put some more black and white boxes like this that are gonna go in the cubbies. And then I've got my pink drawers and the baskets. I'm going to have Sylvanian families along the top of here. I'm going to have shelves up on the wall with these shelves here with more Sylvanian families on. I've got my filing cabinet down here, which I've ordered another plastic file box to go on top because that's not big enough for both my husband and I and the Croft stuff. Those fairy lights and these fairy lights are going up on the walls. And then I've got bookshelves, and so we're going to have up here more shelving with Sylvanian families on, and the clock might go up here above the door. Then I've got cushions, and then here is a pile of stuff that needs to be gone through and sold on eBay. So I've got a lot to do in here. Space, my craft space, my Sylvanian family's display area. This is basically my room of the house. So, yeah, that's the. I'm gonna have pictures on the walls and all this kind of stuff, so I've got a whole heap of pictures to go up on the walls. I've got a basket here full of is just, I've got a lot of ideas, a lot of thoughts, and it's just finding the time to do it. That's the tricky part. And so, I'm hoping that in the next few kind of weeks and months, I'm really going to find my feet a bit better. Because at last, I thought I was doing quite well with finding a routine, but the last couple months have really thrown me completely out of kilter with, you know, being really unwell and everything else that's been going on. So I'm hoping that the next little while is going to be a bit calmer. I kind of feel I need that. But as well as learning how to, what to do with the random time in a day, because I'm still learning how to cope with that. I'm still learning how to I got to start boring. What you saying? Hiya. She's such a snuggle bug. Oh, her tummy is so warm. Your tummy is so warm. Yes, it is. Who's my baby girl? Yeah. I have to be careful where I rub at the moment. She's a little monster. Little monster munch. My phone's gonna run out of memory shortly. I'm gonna finish colouring this pencil in. But yeah, I'm basically just hoping I just find my stride a little bit more in the next. Month or so. And that I'll be in more regular video uploading. Journal.